I gotta get reefer fuel. Let's see. I hate this. No, you're gonna pull ahead. You gotta pull ahead enough that a guy can get reefer fuel. Look at this. This is maybe get another inch, a couple inches. I don't think I'm gonna make it, dude. Let's see if the hose will even make it. I might get lucky. Look at that. That is, I think we're gonna be okay. Let's do it. Put this here for right now. Swipe our cards. I can't believe everything in this life has to be like right on the edge of just barely making it. The guy's even over the yellow line a little bit. I forgot my trip number. I got a new trip here. Reefer only. Now skip. I gotta get my trip number, man. Just a moment. Okay, I got it here. Alright, now I gotta find the right page. It's in here somewhere. What? Okay. Alright, here we go. Okay, trip number. Okay. Still got some more questions to answer. Cash advance, no. 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 Okay. I flipped it up already, right? This is crazy, man. Come on, pump. I did all of this and you're not gonna pump? There she goes. Man, this is stretched out to the max, man. I just need about 10 gallons, I don't know. I'm going to my shipper, I want to make sure I have a full tank before I get there, just in case I got a preload. Could be, I'm pretty sure it's a live load, but still. I got two picks today and I don't want to run out of fuel, let's say that. Taking a shortcut across the Catskill. Hopefully the guy is out of here by the time. By the time I'm done, he'll be pull ahead. I can go back to work. I'm only about maybe 100 miles from my shipper. And I don't have a whole lot of time. Oh, I thought he was taking a shortcut. He went on there crooked. Had to back up. All right. How, you know, I try to hit it on the target on the first try, but you know, sometimes you gotta straighten out. I'm getting close to full. I had to sit out in the street for several minutes, waiting for a spot to open up. There he is. Alright, tell you what, I got some diesel on my fingers. I got chastised by another driver one of my videos that I do for fueling. You know, why don't you wear gloves? You don't wear gloves when you're fueling. There's more than one driver that had a comment about it, but I'll tell you what, if I'm in a hurry, I got this. That's why they say two hands and a foot so you don't slip off. I got this cleanser right here. It's called a fake Pine Sol. It's not Pine Sol, but it's like Pine Sol. Spray some of that on your finger. It's like soap. It's like half cleanser, half water in that. And it's good enough. It's good enough. Whatever doesn't come off on the napkin isn't going to come off on any other surface. Right? It's truck driving. We're not the Queen of England over here trying to stay pristine and clean. All right, back to work. Gotta let my gauges sweep like they do. Let's go to work. Okay. I got my brand new GPS today. I just didn't have time to really set it up right. I mean, it looks really redneck with all the duct tape. I'm putting a piece of tape here up to there, and that'll help support it. But my other GPS, I'll show you. It still works sometimes, but you can see that. I don't know if you can see it. It's cracked right here, or split. I don't know how that happened, but it doesn't have an effect on. It works, still works. The problem is the plug where it plugs in is super sloppy, and the plug just keeps falling out. You know, it won't stay charging easy, in other words. But I can plug it in, and I'm gonna have to transfer manually all my little addresses to my address book on the new one. I have hundreds and hundreds of addresses. Most of them are in my head, but a lot of them, you know, it's so easy to click a city and then hit the address and it'll direct me right there. And even if that's not the exact address, it's close enough. Say it's within 20 miles of the address. Let's say they give me a pre-plan and they don't give me the exact address of the place, but they give me the city. And so I'll push in like Dallas, for example. I think I did on one of the video. And there's a couple places, address book in my Dallas I have in there. So they say, we need you to take this load of Dallas. So I click on Dallas and let's see, I want to go east. And it'll direct me into Dallas and until at such time as I get dispatch, and then I'll be able to check the real address of where I'm going. It helps me trip plan a little bit, I'll say that. See if I have enough hours to get there, that and this and the other. Shoot. Yeah, that's it. That's good work. Still a little bit of snow in the hills. We're in California here. This is like, I believe it's Palm Springs. Tell you right now, North Palm Springs. Looks like a desert to me. I don't see no springs. I used to date this chick for a few years. She worked in an attorney's office in Northern California. This attorney had a blinged out mansion down here in Palm Springs somewhere. I don't know. And she would come down and every once in a while and house sit for him in the summer or whatever. I don't know what year, what month. She was, what are you doing this weekend? Oh, I gotta go house sit. And she would drive his Mercedes down here, his BMW. The guy was rich, wealthy. And she would come down here and I go, can I come with you? She said, well, I don't know. I don't know if my boss would appreciate that. I don't know. But we just dated a few years and then she ended up marrying somebody else and having a kid, which is funny because in a couple years even after that, she's still calling me, what are you doing? Uh-oh. Well, I'm married too. And that was like the last time I heard from her, but I don't know where I'm going with that. Yeah, there's some stuff you gotta take to your grave, you know what I mean? Alright, I went too far already.